I want people to, well, I want to give advice to people who maybe haven't done the campaign yet or are struggling. 800% is now the maximum difficulty. Wait a moment. Let me go ahead and put that into the title also. Apocalypse 800% campaign. Boom. Done. Alright. So let's go over the deck tree real quick. Alright, so I've heard a lot of people actually struggle with the deck tree. Couple of the things over here that are super important for you to get early. One being soldiers. Well, honestly, you don't have to take the soldiers first. But what is super important and most important part of in the early game, in the early stages of the campaign, is a workshop and farm. This is like your priority at the start. You want to get this as early as possible. This is your priority, right? Other than that, a lot of the missions require ballistas. So basically, you're looking to get the farm tech early on, soldiers at some point, and then you want to keep an eye for the ballistas here. So, ranger attack damage into ballistas, which is really good. So, you don't have to rush the soldiers at the start due to the fact that your rangers are going to get the attack damage, 20%. After that, you kind of want to get the logistics. It's pretty huge. I would only get the logistics at the start, though. Nothing else. Like, the train, you can consider that. This is super good, actually. But honestly, like, getting the shocking tower, you want to go get the stone workshop, mainly. Then the Tesla coils, and then shocking tower is really good also. I mean, you need shocking tower. Especially when you play, like, higher difficulty. You will need the shocking tower fairly bad. It is super important to get that. Yeah. So those are like the most important things about the early game, at least, is the shocking tower over here with the stone workshop, farming and ballistas. Then you want to start focusing on the train resources, especially the wood and stone and the iron. This tree over here is super important. It will help you push soldiers early. Because you don't have to build a quarry at any given time in the early game, ever. It is very important. This tree here. But you don't want to rush this tree. If you rush this tree, you're going to be stuck with the campaign. Immediately. You will be stuck. So you don't want to rush this. Right? Otherwise, all of this over here, skip it. Everything over here belongs to skipping. You don't pick any of this. I wouldn't even go for it. I mean, you can consider going for the traps, but you have to take into account that you're gonna be taking two things that you won't need later. So that's like 220 points. So effectively you're wasting 220 points for nothing. So I don't really recommend traps at all. But they can be useful. But I wouldn't recommend it. It's just that wasting those points here is just not worth it. So I'd recommend to stay away from that. Soldier view range and attack range. Super nice. But I don't think it's worth going too early for. Into the campaign. Not exactly worth going too early. You want to get it later on. But yes, you definitely want to get it eventually. Soldier armor is really nice. You can consider taking that, picking this up on the way. So mid game, I decided to get the Lucifers because it makes the horde missions a lot easier. So the advanced machinery over here into mechanical engineering, which will open up new units. They're called Lucifers, and they will make your horde missions much, much easier. Do you think executors are more viable? The problem is that executors are really hard to get to. Look at the amount of points that you're going to need for it. So getting to Shocking Tower is so much easier. It's a lot quicker, less points spent under it. And it's just the... You're going to need those Shocking Towers early. Otherwise, you're going to struggle with those missions a lot. Especially when you play like on 500% or 800%. You will struggle very, very badly. Now, I haven't personally tried out rushing any kind of wasp yet. Where is the wasp? I have not tried that yet. And I was actually thinking about trying it out. The wasp is over here. That's actually really good. Because you can get the soldier damage over here, right? You can get the soldier damage into the wasp. So this is another tree that... Well, you want to get the soldier damage anyway. This is something that you want to get out of the way. It's super good. Right? There is no skipping this. Especially when you're running on high difficulties such as Apocalypse or Nightmare. You really don't want to skip that. You want to pick this up. Now, when should you get a power plant? I don't see any reason to get a power plant until like midway through into the campaign, to be fairly honest. I don't remember when the SimCity mission started. You want to get them into the missions that are like where you have to build a lot and you need a lot of colonists. So into missions such as that require you to have 3,000 population. Anything above 2,000, then you kind of want to have power plants already. But not before that. Okay, so what else? What else do we need to go over with? Then of course you have all these Shocking Tower attack range and whatnot. I wouldn't recommend it. It is good, but it's not specifically needed. The Shocking Tower is already going to do a lot of work for you, the way it is. So the range is like, yeah, it's up a bit, but eh. Yeah, you don't need Lucifers, but here's why I decided to go to Lucis. And it's very important because you can get to, once you get the Lucis open, you only have a couple of points to spend so you can get Titans or Thanatos. And honestly, you're gonna need Titans eventually. At least I felt like with the Titan damage included later, because you get Titan damage over here. Where is it? Titan damage 25%. With this said, once you get the Titans up and running, it makes the regular raids much easier, because Titans are very fast and mobile units that you can maneuver around any specific point where you need to get. So I would always recommend Titans over Thanatos because of their mobility. They're really good. Executors. You need Executors very late into the campaign. I wouldn't recommend picking this up until very, very late. Because I did it on Nightmare and I did not. I built Executors, but I never felt the need for it. Like, a large need, at least. So, don't even... You don't have to put high emphasis on that at all. The wood cutting over here is nice, but... Oh, one thing is... Okay, so this is actually very important. Advanced quarries. Super important to have that, actually. Because you're not really given a lot of stone deposits and iron deposits on the map. Often enough, you'll get up to like 50-something. Which is a very small number if you need to place a lot of walls later. So you're gonna kind of run out of stone. So this is something that you really need to pick up around middle of the campaign. You want to pick this up. 10%, don't pick this up. This is useless. It adds so little on top of the wood production that you have. It's not worth the 120 points. I highly recommend you stay away from this 10%. Defensive barriers is always nice. Okay, what else do we have here? I haven't tried mutants, so I can't really say anything about it. So I'm gonna skip saying something about it. But otherwise, yeah. I mean, late game, clearly I want to go for the trio down here because it's super good. You get buildings energy needed, minus 20%. Tesla energy transfer radius is really nice. So all, like, this entire tree here is like super good. You can just pick all of this up pretty much. Late game, you want to get the transportation as well, of course, because like you get free wasp. Like you actually get them for free, and this will help you hold against raids. So it's a super nice add-on. I think that's about it. Did I miss anything out, chat? Did we miss anything out? It's totally up to you. You don't have to. You don't need any wonders in the game. You don't have to pick these up. You won't need it. You can. This is up to you. But you don't have to. If there's one wonder that you really do want to pick up, it's Academy of Immortals. It's the only wonder that is really powerful into the campaign. Have I played around any gun in? No, I have not. I haven't. I don't think in is useful though. Yeah, I don't see in being useful. I really don't. I don't see it being a viable option. Atlas Transmutator is also amazing. Not really. You tend to have a lot of oil on the map regardless, so I disagree on that. I don't think it's something that you actually want to pick up. You have better things to pick up here, like power plants, Tesla radius, of course units armor, sniper damage. Like all of these are way more important than advanced quarry mining resources plus 20%. You have so many more useful things to pick up than picking up a Atlas Transmutator. Maybe even starting with an extra unit is not a bad idea either. So yeah. Okay. I think I went